Good evening, guys. So Sena here, and I thought we'd take a break from Pokemon this evening so I could give you my thoughts, feelings, and overall review of Superman vs. Batman Dawn of Justice. Where do I start? Zack Snyder returns to direct this sequel to what I thought was a very, very meh Man of Steel. I mean, Henry Cavill has been the greatest Superman since Christopher Reeve. He has finally made people believe that once again a man can fly. And yes, Ben Affleck does a very capable job of Batman. I will hold my hands up and say that I didn't think he would after his shocking performance of Daredevil. The overall premise of the film is it basically combines two of the greatest DC storyline for both Batman and Superman. Mostly it focuses on the Dark Knight Returns, which is the conflict between Superman and Batman. And as the film goes on, it focuses more on the storyline, which I can't say because it'll spoil the film. Those who have read the source material will already know. But yeah, it's not a bad film, but it's not a great film either. It is an improvement on Man of Steel. and Ben Affleck, as I said, does capture the Dark Knight Returns Batman very, very well. It does, however, have some issues, as, you know, pretty much all films do. 2.5 hours is a long sit-in. I'll admit I wasn't bored at all throughout the entire film. It could do with being half hour shorter. It really could. And I don't think Wonder Woman was needed at all. Certainly not in the capacity that she was used in the film. There were other points. I had other points. What was I going to say? This is terrible. no, the one thing that DC do well is their animated universe. Their animated film universe, which I own a good majority of, and they are all fantastic. You know, I can sit there and enjoy the 75 minutes worth of viewing that they offer, and I come away completely completely happy. I went to a local independent cinema to watch the film tonight, and I'm glad the entry fee was only £2.50. I would have been very disappointed had I gone to a Cineworld or a View and paid £10-11 for a ticket. I mean, it's a strong 7, as I said. It's a strong sort of boost up from Man of Steel, and it will obviously lead into the other films of the DC Universe that they have planned: The Flash, Aquaman, Cyborg, Wonder Woman's going to get her own film. I think Ben Affleck is set to appear in Suicide Squad, but I'm not entirely sure. Obviously, I'm sure they're doing another solo Superman movie. Who else do they focus on? Cyborg. I'm not sure if Cyborg will get his own solo movie. The Flash definitely will. Aquaman will. Maybe they'll introduce Green Arrow. But that's the one thing that really sort of grinds on me, is DC... DC are running the show with their TV shows. Marvel are beating them in the cinematic universes in feature-length films. Maybe it's because they've got 8 years, or pretty much 8 years, worth of extra films on them. Or maybe just Marvel are better at it. But DC have arrived very, very late to the party. And the problem with DC is they've only got about 6 recognisable heroes, and I've just listed them all. So outside of that, there's not a lot really they can do except, I don't know, a trilogy for each film, for each hero, and then a couple of Justice League films, which I'm sure is the plan. But yeah, on TV, the show Arrow based on the Green Arrow. He's now halfway through its fourth season, or it's now more than halfway through its fourth season, sorry. And the actor who plays Oliver Queen, Stephen Amell, is fantastic. I didn't see within Dawn of Justice whether or not they could... This has turned into more of a rant about DC rather than the film. Shut up, phone. But yeah, that's the one thing the DC don't do well. Or maybe they will do it well, I don't know. But Stephen Amell has been playing the Arrow for nearly 4 years. Grant Gustin, who plays the Flash in the TV series, has got nearly two series under his belt. But they show an image of the Flash, as by way of introducing him, I suppose, which is absolutely fine. But it's not Grant Gustin, it's a different actor. And I think the DC should have looked at it and gone, well, surely he's performing so well on television. I know certain actors can't do it, aren't made for film acting as opposed to television acting. And the Dawn of Justice itself is quite dark. And the Flash TV series is very light-hearted. It's not comedy, but it's certainly more light-hearted than what Man of Steel or Dawn of Justice have been. So maybe that's their thinking there, to bring in a different actor who maybe could portray a better version of the Flash within a darker universe. I just think it's a bit unfair to have a look at the actors that are doing so well on telly and then not give them the chance to portray themselves on film, or in a movie, sorry. But yeah, overall, I mean, I will be purchasing Dawn of Justice. Probably not when it first comes out. Probably wait for it to come down in price somewhat. If you're into, like, action flicks and you just want to go and see it because it's Superman versus Batman, go and see it, because you will be entertained. But for 2.5 hours, make sure you go to an independent cinema like I did. If you're somebody who's hardcore into their comics, or at least knows the source material like I do, I think a lot of people similar to myself would say that it's disappointing. I mean, the reviews it has gotten on critic websites like Rotten Tomatoes, IMDb, actually they haven't scored it too badly, IMDb, but a lot of critics have slated it. It's not as bad as they're saying, but it's not as good as it could have been. I was feeling apprehensive going in anyway, mostly due to the negative reviews and to the fact that I didn't think Ben Affleck was going to be a good Batman. I came away pleasantly surprised, but, you know, it's... I just feel that Marvel are doing it so much better than DC. I'm not saying I prefer Ben Affleck as Batman to Christian Bale, because I don't. I think Christian Bale does it a lot better, or did it a lot better, I should say. However, as I... I think I might have said it earlier, Ben Affleck portrays the Dark Knight Batman, the Dark Knight Returns Batman, very, very well. And I also prefer Jeremy Irons as as Alfred the Butler, as opposed to Michael Caine, because as the comics went on, Alfred was no longer seen as just a butler. You know, an English butler who had come over to America and was employed by the Wayne family. He's actually a former... I'm not sure if he was a Marine or whether he was just in part of the Royal British Army or what have you. But he's now seen as more of a bodyguard rather than a butler. It does give a certain nod to other... other people that have played, not other people that have played Batman or Superman, to the original source material, which I found very, very good. As I said, the inclusion of Wonder Woman, particularly the part she does have, I don't feel was warranted, was needed. And I just felt that, I don't know, the way that Batman and Superman finally set aside their differences, bit of a cop-out, bit of a crock. But yeah, that's pretty much it, because I feel that I should have put that on for them. Never mind, maybe next time. I do plan on doing more film reviews, unless this one completely and utterly sucks and I receive nothing but negative comments. But as for the film itself, a lot of people were coming away saying it's, you know, 2 out of 5 stars, or, you know, 4 out of 10. I reckon it's probably a 7, at least. Probably bordering on a 7.6, 7.7. Something along those lines. There were just, I don't know, maybe I'm just being too biased because Marvel have done it so well and DC have arrived very, very late to the party. And just seem to want to throw everything into one film to just try and make it stick, so to become as popular as Marvel's cinematic universe. But yeah, overall it's a good film. You know, Superman is Superman. I think that's the one thing that bugs me as well. Henry Cavill, I mean, I grew up with my, the first time I ever saw, sorry, I said that I was going to wrap it up and now I'm going to go on a bit of a tangent. The first time I saw Superman portrayed on telly was Dean Cain in Lois and Clark, and that showed Superman, you know, standing up for truth, justice in the American way. And then as I got older, I read more of Superman's backstory, and he was actually a bit of a bastard. Partly because I don't think his powers were as developed back in 1938 as they are, you know, as they've gone on to be. But Henry Cavill, he just doesn't seem to play a nice Superman. You know, Superman and Batman, I've always seen them as a yin and a yang. They sort of clash off each other. Whereas now they just seem to be, like, Batman's always angry and broody, but Superman appears to be that for no good reason. I don't know. Maybe that's just me being stupid or me being cynical. But yeah, overall, probably a 7.6 if I'm adding point numbers in. Worth a watch, but as I said, don't go to a Cineworld or a View or anything. Don't pay extravagant prices for it. If you can find an independent cinema that sells it for a fiver a ticket, then go nuts. But otherwise, wait for the DVD. That's all there is to be said. As I said, I do plan on doing more of these, unless this one completely dive bombs and everybody hates it and everyone says that I suck. I might just stick to playing Pokemon, which I actually know a bit about. But yeah, that's it from me, guys. Thank you very much for watching. I've been Osana, and that's been my review on Superman vs. Batman Dawn of Justice. If you somehow enjoyed this, like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. I really do appreciate it. And I will talk to you guys when there's actual gameplay up on the screen, so you'll be entertained by that rather than me chatting absolute bollocks. Alright, cheers, guys. Bye.